it always struck me as really bizarre that there are trainers and coaches everywhere doing the work we do. And if we ask them, what is fitness? I mean, first of all, you say, what do you do? I'm a strength conditioning guy. What's a strength conditioning coach? What does that do? Well, you make people fit. Okay, good. What's fitness? Well, I don't know. You know, you couldn't get an answer. Ask trainers, ask coaches, ask yourself, what is fitness? It's kind of a tough one to answer. What we thought was really bizarre, if not unprofessional or irresponsible, to be trying to chase down some holy grail of fitness without at least having some sense of what it was you were after. How can you pursue something that you're unable to define? It's a little bit hairy. And so what we've done is over the years, we've developed some models, we call them, that describe for us what it is that we're after. And that has been an exciting part of our success, I believe. And a large part of our efficacy lies in the fact that we have clearly defined what it is that we call fitness, what it is that we don't consider fit. Because it's made it so that we can have a singular focus in moving towards some goal. And I want to share with you now what those models are. The first of these, and this is, we're at 8A on your sheet here, is a capacity in random tasks. And we have at times referred to this both as an operative or a statistical definition of fitness. But check this out. What I want to be able to do is, and we just highlighted, talked about this yesterday informally, what I'd like to be able to do is throw into a bucket all kinds of training modalities. And we pick these things and we challenge people to do them. And my claim is, my assertion is, that whomever does best statistically at these randomly selected physical tasks is fittest. And that, in fact, is the fitness that we're training for. I am very impressed by good results on standardized tests. I'm even more impressed if you haven't studied specifically for that test. I'm really excited if you've never done any of those activities before and you do really well at it. And I'm supremely impressed if I can pick tasks for which you have no training, no experience, and you can do better even than people that have worked at those tasks. That's rare, but it happens. But in the nature of military work, fire work, and police work, we often don't know all of the circumstances. Do you need to be fast? Sure. Do you need to be strong? You bet. Do you need to have a good wind? Yeah. And what quality don't you need? And in what order do you need these things? We cannot state for sure.